This week on American Airgunner, we're traveling to Cleveland, Ohio to check out Pyramid Air's new facility, where we'll get to know the company and hang out with owner Josh Unger. Rick Buesler is going to be reviewing the Umarex Surge, and the guys are back at the round table talking about some of the most common mistakes made with air guns. All this and more coming up right now. All right, so I've flown across the country to Cleveland, Ohio to finally meet the man himself from Pyramid Air, Mr. Josh Unger. Now, I hear he's wild and crazy. I don't know. I know a few guys from Pyramid Air, but I've never got a chance to meet the man himself. This is Pyramid Air. Nice. I'm looking for Josh Unger. Hello, sir. Are you Mr. Unger?
I heard of that.
Yeah?
I've been cold worse than that.
This is the man. This is Pyramid Air. This is the CEO, Josh Unger. Let's go have some fun,
like,
shall we?
Calling me names like CEO, I don't quite understand.
Where are we going?
Let's go to the most important room.
The most important room?
Warehouse.
Ah, yes. Should I actually grab a shopping cart now?
Well, this is the warehouse.
So this is the warehouse.
We started with 438 square feet.
How big is this?
75,000 square feet.
75,000. Now, this is new. How new is this? This is a new facility.
About a year old.
Okay.
Yeah, we bought it about a year ago, less than a year ago. All these are, in the boxes, are foam inserts to ship pellets in. These are returns from a year or so ago that need parts. From here, they go to the customer.
What all do you manufacture here?
Usually, it's parts that are impossible to get somewhere else. People send us broken down stuff that doesn't exist anymore. Let's say brass O-ring.
Right.
We can do it right here. We'd start with something like this.
All right.
And it comes out a beautiful,
shiny piece of brass.
Yeah.
These machines you have are capable of making any screw, any O-ring, any barrel strap for any type of gun. Anywhere.
This is where I play. Right there. Some people request for me to manufacture for them different kind of pellets. So,
okay.
These are the examples.
Okay. Oh, with like four, those are steel tips.
Steel tips. And this will go in and this will make a really, really good dinner.
So can I make one or not?
Oh, for God's sake. Does he have insurance?
I'm insured. Insured it, enough. I want to make one and take it home for as a,
sure.
You know.
Oh, in that case. So, but if you'll take home a big bubble.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so.
Okay, put. Well, okay, so, don't worry about it. Put one in.
Right.
Then drop this one in. Push this button on top.
Okay. How far?
Keep going. Keep more.
That's it.
Now push button on the bottom. And here's your.
Nice. Look at that.
This is shipping.
Okay.
This.
And this is shopping.
This is shopping.
This is the shopping section.
Yes. This is where we actually keep our inventory. And this is all pellets.
Slingshot. Man, I haven't shot a slingshot in forever. Is that my shopping cart? Is that what this is?
Yes.
This is my shopping cart? This is what I'm talking about. This is what I've been waiting for. How many guns can I fit on this thing?
One.
This is a big one. All right, I will catch up with you in your office later.
Bye.
Woo. Mr. Unger, I am tired, man. I appreciate that.
What are you doing?
Thanks for the tour. I enjoyed it.
No, wait a minute.
I'm gonna see you later. I'll catch you later. All right, well, unfortunately, I tried, but I could not get out of the building with any of that stuff that I went shopping for. Unger just wasn't having it, which I understand. But we are going to meet him tomorrow at his farm to shoot all kinds of guns. You name it, we're going to shoot it, so we shall see. Maybe tomorrow I'll walk away with some freebies. We'll be back. Don't go away. When we come back, we'll be at the round table. This week's topic, some of the most common mistakes with air guns. American Air Gunner is sponsored by Umarex, zeroed in, by Pyramid Air, the world's largest retailer of air guns, and by Hotson, serious, solid impact.
The pistols you've watched in action for generations and the ones you've always wanted to own are now within your reach. Introducing Umarex Action Pistols. These high-quality replica pistols, powered by CO2, look, shoot, and feel just like a powder burner. Plus, ammo is economical and always available. Boomer X Action Pistols. From the past, present, and shooting into the future.
The Umarex Octane features tremendous velocity with a quiet downrange noise thanks to the integrated Silence Air Noise Dampening System. Powered by the Reaxis gas piston that provides more punch, more power, and more speed. These two technologies combined deliver a smooth, accurate shot with maximum power. The Umarex Octane.
PyramidAir.com. Let's see.
That was fast.
Bingo.
Honey, did you do those chores yet?
Chores?
Lawn.
Roger, put that drink down. We gotta mow. Chop, chop.
Oh, yeah. He's out there showing the grass he's boss.
Pyramid Air. Big selection, fast shipping, the air gun experts.
Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to the roundtable this week. I'm joined today by Rick Usler, Jim Chapman, and Tom Gaylord. Let's talk common mistakes. I know a lot of people, we assume that people just know about guns, how to handle them, and that they would know how to shoot air guns. What are the common mistakes you run into from beginners all the way up to the experienced?
The biggest mistake I run into, and then people contact me, they claim the gun's inaccurate. My first question is, do you have any experience with shooting a high-powered Springer? And their response is no. I just am used to shooting rimfire. Mm-hmm. And what they did is they went and found the gun that had the highest feet per second they could find, mm-hmm. and they buy that gun, and I said, are you shooting from a rest or are you using the artillery hold? He says, well, I have it in a vise. And so, you know, just these things, they're trying to take, you know, how they would normally handle a firearm and transition that to this Ultra Magnum Springer, and that's never gonna work.
So biggest common mistakes, well, let's just start with Springers.
Yep.
Holding them. What do you have to do to get a good hold on a Springer?
You wanna demonstrate that with 34?
I was gonna answer, but Tom is actually the father of this technique.
Yeah. Well, I didn't create the
technique. I know, but you're the one who communicated
it
to
us. I call it the artillery hold. Okay. You ever see an old war movie, where the artillery piece fires and the barrel goes back 3 feet?
Sure.
But those things can hit 5 miles away. And the reason they do is, while the barrel moves, the gun carriage doesn't.
Okay.
And the barrel always comes back to the same place. Mm-hmm. So instead of holding this thing like a deer rifle, grabbing it and pulling it in tight, trying to control it, you want to lay it on the flat of your open palm. You want to hold it here at the pistol grip very lightly. Don't pull it into your shoulder and let it recoil as much as it wants to. What happens is you set up the same vibration pattern time and time and time again.
One part of that technique too is really critical, is to maintain the hold after you've fired the shot.
Yeah, follow through.
Yeah, the follow through part of it is really critical.
You see that with hunters a lot. They'll get out there, they'll shoot a game, and they'll pop up to see what happens before. And it takes some discipline to stay on your target, do the follow through, let the pellet clear, and just keep tracking. It's a good shooting habit, regardless of what you're shooting. It goes along with what you're saying. The most common mistake I see are people buy a gun because of the velocity stated.
Rossi, you pick this up.
Mm-hmm.
That's the RWS 34, and it started hundreds of thousands of air gunners over the years.
Okay.
It's not a super expensive rifle, but it's
nice.
Not cheap.
Right.
It's got a very nice trigger nowadays.
Yep.
Accuracy is incredible.
Let's talk real quick, just since we're on Springers, but gun kind of common mistakes in general. Cocking with a brake barrel. What are a lot of things you see out there, just common mistakes people make?
Once you cock that brake barrel, hang on to the end of the barrel.
Break it down and hold it.
Don't let go.
Right.
Because anything mechanical can fail, and if it does and your finger is up there loading a pellet, mm-hmm. you aren't going to get it out in time.
Let's talk PCPs. What are some common mistakes people you see with PCPs as far as just getting the air in the gun?
A common one is I see them overfilling the gun. They figure if it's going to do X velocity or X energy at 3,000 PSI, 3,500 PSI is going to be better.
Yeah.
And you can actually lock the gun up so it won't even work.
Yeah.
The other thing that I think is pretty common, people don't look for the sweet spot in their gun. Mm-hmm. So they fill up the PCP and they expect to start getting a consistent high velocity at the highest pressure. And what you actually see, most of these guns, even if they filled to 3,000 PSI, it might be at 2,700 PSI where they get the maximum efficiencies and the highest velocities.
People wonder, well, can I put nitrogen in my gun? Well, yes, air is almost 80% nitrogen. You can do that. Well, can I put argon? I'm a welder. I've got to settle it. You know, it goes crazy. Let's use air.
Can I put helium in there? Yeah.
You actually can.
You'll talk funny. Yeah, but I use nitrogen a lot of times because it's easier to get at. It doesn't harm the gun.
Let's talk about just little mistakes people make just with guns.
I know a gentleman who is unfortunately a personality, not you,
right?
Who was holding a Career 707 and he always put his finger on the trigger and he shot himself in the arm and it went 8 inches into his arm. Had to have it taken out at the hospital.
Oh, yowza. Yeah,
but you have to practice the same safety you do with any gun. Don't put your finger on the trigger until you're ready to shoot it. Don't point the barrel at anything you don't intend to shoot. Another thing for hunters is being aware of your backdrop. I mean, everybody has to do that, but hunters, you're in a constantly changing environment and you get adrenaline pumping through you. You see a squirrel moving through the trees, you want to take the shot. You have to think about what's back there and always be aware of safety in terms of where that pellet's going to end up.
You want another common one? People will buy a pellet trap that's rated for a 600 foot per second gun. They'll shoot a 1200 foot per second gun. They'll put a hole. Yep.
Yeah.
Every time, and they don't know it.
Right.
They don't know it until they notice all the holes in the drywall behind.
And let's talk common mistakes real quick about storing guns.
Storing them in cases with foam liners. There are two types of foam, closed cell and open cell. And if you don't know what you have and you have open cell, it's hygroscopic. It attracts moisture from the air. It stays in the foam. It'll rust your gun.
Oh, that's what happened to my gun.
I'm thinking now.
Information that would have been more useful to me about a year ago. When I took my gun, I was like, what happened? Okay, guys, obviously a lot of great safety tips. Thank you so much. I think that's all the time we've got today. So there you go for more safety tips and just things to be aware of when you're in the air gun world. Go to our website, AmericanAirGunner.com. A lot more American Air Gunner coming up right now. Stay with us. All right, guys, when we return, Rick Usler shares his thoughts on the Umarex surge.
Quiet Energy, a new line of PCP air guns from Hatsan USA, available in 177, 22, and 25 calibers. The Quiet Energy line of air guns is perfect for serious target practice as well as small to medium-sized game hunting. The new Quiet Energy series delivers more usable shots per fill and puts more energy downrange while keeping the noise levels to minimum. If you're looking for power and accuracy in a quiet air gun, your search is over with the Quiet Energy line of PCP air guns from Hatsan USA. Life can be loud, but sometimes silence is golden. Introducing the Umarex Fusion Air Rifle with a combination of CO2 power, the Silence Air 5 chamber noise dampener, and a precision rifled barrel. The Fusion is a bona fide tech driver that's the quietest air rifle you'll ever own. Experience silence with the Umarex Fusion at umarexusa.com/FusionTV.
We're here at Air Gun Web with Rick Usler, and he's our resident gun critic, and he has been now for two seasons on American Air Gunner. So I wanted to come here and see exactly what Rick does. So here we are. We have the Umarex Surge, literally right out of the box. It has a tag on it. You put the scope on. Haven't taken a shot with it or anything, so I'm ready to see what it takes to actually review a gun.
Well, first thing is we don't have a week. So we're going to do this, the short version, okay?
Okay, this is the fast-forwarded version.
Right, so basically what you're going to need to do before you do anything is just shoot it. Mm-hmm. We're not too concerned about accuracy yet. We have to get through the break-in period. We don't have time to do that right now because we just did take this out of the box.
Tell me about this gun first. Who is this for? What kind of gun is this?
This is a, well, it's, first of all, it's under $100.
Okay.
So the price point is very, very aggressive. Mm-hmm. If you've got a youngster, it's very easy to cock, very lightweight. It's really, I think, designed for that new air gunner.
Okay.
Very easy to shoot. You just get it out of the box. You've read the instructions. You've mounted the scope properly.
You don't read the instructions. Well, you should, but he doesn't.
No, what happens?
He's lying.
Yes, I'm encouraging people to read the instructions so that they mount the scope properly. Mm-hmm. Once that's all tightened down, now you can start actually just working with the gun. So the first thing we're going to do is just fire some shots into the
pellet. See if it actually shoots.
Yes, absolutely. So we'll take this. Now, these guns are break barrel, so you just pull it down. So always secure the barrel. Put in our pellet. Close the barrel. Remember, I'm always keeping my finger away from the trigger until I'm ready
safety
to shoot
first.
All the safety stuff. Well, when you cock the barrel, the gun automatically goes on safe. So now I'm going to go ahead and disengage the safety.
Okay.
Aim it at my pellet trap. And there we go. The gun is definitely firing.
It does fire. Right. And of course, we are shooting in a safe environment, which you should make sure you always do.
Right. I have actually what I use is I have a 22 rimfire bullet trap.
Okay,
so it's not going anywhere.
So you've taken the gun out of the box, you know that it shoots, so now how do you go about actually testing so you can give the people out there a good review of a gun?
First thing I'm going to test is just the out-of-the-box velocity.
Okay.
So I've got my chronograph here, and we'll turn it on.
So you know how many feet per second you're getting out of the gun?
Exactly.
Okay, so this one says what? How many feet per second do we think
with,
this gun?
With lead pellets, you're supposed to get 1,000 feet per second.
Okay.
All right. Now, I always test with the RWS Hobbies, which are about the lightest lead pellet. They're my baseline pellet, whether 22 or 177. I always use the Hobbies. I always have. So we'll go ahead and cock the gun. And I'm going to fire again at the trap. This time, the chronograph's on.
Right. All right, so first one measured 1072.6, so 1,072 feet per second.
Out of the box.
Right out of the box.
Out of the box. Okay. And if you don't have a chronograph, man, if you're into the hobby, definitely get one. They're a ton of fun.
Okay, what's next?
You know, next is just gonna be sighting in the rifle, which we probably don't have time to do that on camera today, but I would set up, sight in the rifle with my basic pellets, and then just go through the break-in process.
That's the purpose of finding what pellet works specifically for this gun right. to get your best grouping, right?
Right.
Okay, so once you do that, what else do you test?
I test trigger pull.
Okay, how do you do that?
Well, I've got this handy dandy little tool here, and this is a trigger pull gauge.
Okay.
Okay, now, this is the fun part. Make sure safety's off or you're gonna get a really heavy trigger pull. And out of the box, now you'd do that a couple times as well to get an average, but
sure.
You know, our first pull is 3 pounds, 4.3 ounces.
3 pounds, 4.3 ounces.
But that's actually for a budget air gun.
Yeah.
That's very good.
All right, what else do you test on a gun? Sound, what about sound?
You know, we could dip into the old sound meter.
Let's dip into the old sound meter.
I actually have one. Here is my handy dandy dB meter.
Everything around here seems to be handy dandy.
It is. Now, I'll tell you what I do is I don't have this right next to the gun. I want to get shot noise and mechanical noise.
Okay.
So if it's behind me, I'm going to get more mechanical noise. If it's all the way in front of me, I'm going to get more shot noise. So what I do, I put this at about a 45 degree angle, about 15 feet away.
Okay.
And I'm indoors, so it's really going to be, this is my indoor test, and I also test outdoors. I actually have some silent traps rigged up on my backstop. So I'm shooting into a silent medium so that the only sound I'm getting is the mechanicals and the shot noise.
Okay.
We registered a pretty stout 104.
104. You literally test everything there is to do on a gun from top to bottom.
I do.
And how long does it take to get a true read of what a gun is before you put the review out there? How long do you spend on it?
I've done a little work on that. I've tried to think about that. I average between 20 and 30 hours per gun.
The guy spends a lot of time by himself. So, well, okay, Rick, so obviously you put these guns through the paces, and when you put out a review, let's be honest, it's from top to bottom, you're getting everything there is to know about a gun.
Facts, not fluff.
Right.
That's my motto, is facts, not fluff.
So you put the truth out there.
I try to.
Don't go anywhere, because when we come back, it's time to start the Hunger Games. Stay with us. All right, it's time for our American Airgunner Trivia, brought to you this year by our friends at Blue Book Publications.
A legend in innovation and tradition. These classical and modern masterpieces have sent pellets downrange for over three decades. German engineered to last a lifetime. Quality, power, precision. RWS, the world's finest air rifles.
All right, so it's day two here in Ohio. Yesterday was a great day at Pyramid here, hanging out, get to meet a lot of great people. But today, Mr. Josh Unger's invited me out to his farm for a little friendly air gun competition. So let's go see if we can find him. Found him. Yo, yeah, ho, 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 hey, ho, yowza.
What?
That's not an air gun.
No, I'm altering geese flight to Canada.
You're also altered my eardrum. What were you shooting at there?
Well, there are geese come from Canada, and I want to just get rid of them. They're sky rats as far as I'm concerned.
Oh, you're just scaring them?
Scaring them. It's illegal to shoot them because they taste terrible.
Oh.
Pyramid Air is perhaps the largest internet air gun store in the world. I established Pyramid Air as a venue to teach kids to shoot correctly. And it went from there. I put up one gun for sale, another gun for sale. I was the first company in the world to have an air gun website.
Quickly, run me through what I'm looking at here. What guns are these? What is this? What is this beauty?
This is a bullpup.
And I see it's got the side lever.
Correct.
As opposed to, because a lot of theirs have the electronic, right?
Right?
The semi-automatics?
It's better this way.
Then came the first catalog, a one page, one side, and the rest is history. Then I moved down into my basement, huge basement, 400 square feet. I moved to my first warehouse, 2,000 square feet. I thought I'd never fill it. 2 weeks later, I had no place to walk.
I've only seen this in pictures. I've been dying to get my hands on.
Well, don't die.
No sniper.
And we started spreading. Going through the doors, through the walls in the warehouse, and going from 2,000 feet to 3,000 feet to 6,000 feet, it was not enough. And we bought a warehouse, our first warehouse, uh-huh. And that was 20 some odd thousand square feet. We filled it before we knew what to do with it. Right? So now we are in a warehouse, 75,000 square feet. This is a dream. It's a dream warehouse. We have another 5 years of growth left there.
What is, in fact, the competition?
No, this is just to show people what you can do. And competition is silly. You're an excellent shot and so am I. We can do it. But let's just show people what can be done for fun.
You have to understand it's not only safe, but it's cheap. The biggest expense is like car. First is car, then gasoline. First rifle is expensive. Pellets are cheap.
You got it on the first shot. See?
You have 500 shots in one tin. How long would it take you to shoot 500 shots? For $10 versus $160 or something like it?
Bingo!
That's why we're here. That's why we're here. Well, let me shoot one, and then you'll shoot the second one. This is an airsoft with an attitude.
Why do I believe it's not an airsoft? Holy! I think you got it. I'm gonna say you win.
Of course.
Of course.
We are an entertainment business. We are in serious entertainment business. This is what Pyramid is all about, fun. And stop interrogating me, because I'm not going to tell you any more than that.
Deal.
Okay?
Good?
All right.
All right. Next week on American Air Gunner, we're getting down and dirty with some DIY. That's do-it-yourself, as I'll be showing you one of the many ways to build your own pellet trap. Jim Chapman is across the world coming to us from the plains of Africa. And of course, we'll be at the round table. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.